believe that there are many people like Isa that are here, and I have a great heart to see our soldiers come to God. The fact that our church is positioned right here and in this community, the primary reason that this community exists is because of Garrison Petawawa, and this church is full of either active or retired military, and I love it. I'm thankful for it, and I'm so excited about young soldiers that are making a decision that they want to give their lives to serve the Lord. Amen. And so we're going to pray with Isa. Amen. I guess I'm going to pray with you before I get you in the water, since I'm already started. Amen. But let's a few gather around. I know that Judy has been praying and working with her some, and trying to teach and help her along the way. Amen. But let's pray. Pray over Isa's life and pray for her family. I know that that's her heart's desire, that God, what God is doing in her life would impact others. In the name of Jesus, God, I thank you, Lord God, for Isa and her choice, Lord, to serve you. I thank you for the courage of this young lady, Lord, that she's reaching out in hunger for you. And God, I feel your spirit here right now, God. I believe you're going to do something special, Lord, not only in Isa, but through Isa, Lord. I pray today that this would be a red letter day in her life, that she would forever remember, Lord, this moment, God, where she made a decision, Lord, and I pray that you would bless her with your favor and your power. Touch her, oh Lord, I ask in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. As your Lord and Savior today. Yes. All right. So I'm going to have you sit down, and you're going to take your left hand and cover your nose with it, and your right hand, you just grab this forearm, and I'm going to hang on to you here. All right. Sano is the correct pronunciation of your last name?
Yes.
Sano. Okay. Isa Sano, on confession of your faith and in obedience to the Word of God, I now baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of all your sins. Barbara was a surprise last-minute addition for me, and this week she came to my sister's closet, and I don't know what you came looking for, but you may have found more than you bargained for. Yeah, well, there we go, and it worked, amen. And through that conversation, I know that Sister Kathy was spending some time with Barbara, and then Brad had an opportunity, and they prayed together, and I kind of came in a little bit late on the conversation because I believe it was Thursday. I got a call from Kathy saying that there's a lady here who's interested in being baptized, and so I talked to Barbara on the phone, and here she is, and I'm so thankful that also her son is here today, and her oh, right over here, and her daughter-in-law, and so we are so glad that they are here to support her. Amen. We even have a light show to go with this. This is a performance, I guess. But I'm just catching up to getting to know Barbara, but God's known her for a long time. And what's important here is that the work that God has been doing, and I believe what I'm so heartened by things like this because it reminds me that I don't know everything. I don't know all that God is doing. And so sometimes we may be praying and wondering, God, are you hearing prayers? But God is working on people throughout this community and touching their hearts because he loves them. Amen. And I'm so excited for that here today. And so we're going to pray over Barbara and her life, her family, that God would do a special work in them. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray right now, God, for Barbara. I thank you, Lord God, for, Lord, the work you've already done to lead her to this day, Lord, that she came, Lord, already hungry and seeking after you. And God, I thank you, Lord, for, God, those from the church, Lord, that reached out to her, Lord, and helped God to lead her to this moment. And Father, I'm asking right now that you would bless Barbara's life in a beautiful way. God, I pray, Lord, that you would touch her, Lord, that God, this day would be transformative in her walk with you, Lord, and that you would work in her and her family, her friends. God, that you would shine a light through her and that this would not be the end of a search, but rather the beginning of a new life in Christ, I pray. In Jesus' name, we ask for the work to be done. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And Barbara, have you asked Jesus to forgive your sins? Do you believe he's done that? Are you confessing as your Lord and Savior?
Almost definitely.
All right. So I'm going to have you use your left hand and cover your nose and then grab onto that left forearm with your right hand so I have something to hang on to. Yeah, just put that over on your forearm.
Yeah.
Okay, I got it. There we go. All right. Barbara McInnes, upon confession of your faith and in obedience to the word of God, I now baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of all your sins. I'm going to have Pastor Kingsley take over, and I'm going to help him. He has been working with Brother Lloyd and his family for a while here, and I'm thankful because this is a... Sometimes you wonder when a faithful saint like Sister McDonald passes away, is that the end of an era? But I'm thankful that God is continuing to work in the Hudson family. Amen. And I'm going to let Pastor Kingsley take over from here.
Thank you. Praise the Lord, folks.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Ryder, do you want to come around? You can come right in here. You saw the gathering. Oh, that's what you got. It's no problem for a boy.
That's right. Just jump on.
Then step down there. Woo! Then I'm going to put you down from there. Does it feel all right? You happy? Good. This boy's 11 years old.
Yes, awesome.
A lot of time to serve the Lord.
That's right, amen.
Good looking boy, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
What really brings us all to where we are is that Lloyd Hudson, right here, the grandfather, the great-grandfather, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, him and his wife, because I've known them for many years, and... He has talked to the family about baptism in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. And the family's been anxious to do it.
Yeah.
They want to do it.
Right.
It's not the other way around. So we thank God for this family and for Ryder. So I was over there teaching them a couple weeks ago or so on repentance, baptism, the Holy Ghost. And so I said, anybody got any questions? Ryder says, how long do you keep them under?
Amen.
Well, that's a good question. And we had a good answer. You forgot. Listen.
You're ready to go away?
Yeah.
You give your life to the Lord full and completely. Amen.
Did you see how you put your hand up? Don't squeeze it until I am ready. Because you might take your own breath away. Brother Abbott, will you pray, please?
Yes. Lord Jesus, God, we thank you, Lord, for righteous life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God, for what I see in this boy.
Thank you,
Jesus. Sincerity, Lord, and a desire to please you. I pray, God, that you would touch him right now, Lord, and that this day, God,
my God,
would impact, Lord, the course of the rest of writers.
My
Lord,
God.
God, that what he is doing here today would mark
thank
him,
you,
God,
Jesus.
As a man who has a heart after you.
Thank you, Jesus.
After you, God, and to serve you throughout his life, God, touch him, I pray, oh Lord, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus, you give it to Ethan.
Okay.
Just keep it.
Thank you, Jesus. Now, Ryder.
Just before I put it.
Upon the confession of your faith and obedience to the word of God, I baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Well, Amy,
here we are.
This is one of the greatest days of your life.
Amen. Amen.
And I want you to enjoy it.
Yes.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
It's a gift from God.
Yes.
Even Jesus as a man was baptized.
That's right.
To be an example, to fulfill all righteousness.
Thank you.
So for us to be baptized is a wonderful experience.
Yes.
To follow in the path of the early church.
Yes.
The book of Acts. All that goes with it.
Just one.
No, you just squeeze your nose.
Okay.
And hold on there. And,
all right.
And don't squeeze it until I start putting you down.
I can breathe now.
You can breathe.
Okay.
What's your name again?
Amy.
Yeah, Amy. Amy, upon the confession of your faith and obedience to the word of God, I baptize you in Jesus' name.
Thank
Amen.
You.
Well, I am covered by his blood, walking by faith, living in love. I am covered by his blood. Jesus has rescued me. Oh, I am covered by his blood.
about this?
Yes.
It's a great day. And the longer you live and the more you read and study the Bible and people preach to you, you're going to find that what you know today is wonderful, but God has more for us. There's always more. In the name of the Lord. This boy's name is Rock.
Yes.
Holy Rock.
32.
32.
Thank you, Jesus.
God's been good to you.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Put your hands up.
Thank you.
Just one to squeeze your nose. One I'm going to put you down, and one just so I have something to hold on. Okay, Rock. Confession of your faith in an obedience to the word of God. We now baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
This is Debbie, yes. The mother, yes. Ryder, and the other little girl. It's good to have her here. It's a great step, Debbie. And these folks have not shunned it. They've never asked any other questions about any other church, why we do this or why we do that. It's just simply teach the Bible, the word of God. I'm so excited to receive it and hear it and obey it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless you, Debbie. It's going to make you a better mother.
Well, I hope so.
She doesn't need to be a better mother.
Maybe even a better mother. Maybe even a better wife, eh?
I'll never know.
Good water because you're in it in the name of Jesus.
Yes. Yeah.
Can you guys do a prayer for her? She's going through a lot.
Yes.
And also, before you dunk her.
Yes. Lord, we pray, God, right now, Lord, that you would move in Debbie's life. God, you see, Lord, the things she's dealing with in her body, Lord. God, we are asking right now, Lord, that God, as she is baptized, that you would do a work, God, of healing, Lord, and restoration, that you would touch her, Lord, by your spirit. I pray, God, that your power would rest upon her life, God, that there would be something that's transformed in this family and in Debbie's life, Lord.
Lead
in
you, Jesus.
God, I believe, Lord, right now, for the power of your presence, Lord. In Jesus' name, oh God, let your work be done, Lord, in her life. We believe for it, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Everything.
Hallelujah.
People that have been baptized have been very sick.
Thank you, Jesus.
And God has not only forgiven their sins, but he has healed.
That's right.
In the name of Jesus. We can expect anything from the Lord.
Right.
He's a wonderful Savior. He knows what he's doing. And we're here at that wonderful state of Israel. You want to put your hands up?
Let's change your nose.
Thank you.
Have this is quite important.
Oh, sorry.
No, no, here, put that one up there. Ooh,
woo! Like I float, I float.
Yeah, I see that. That's good. That's good. Better float than drowning. Now, Debbie, upon the confession of your faith in obedience to the word of God, I now baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name.